Myself, Dr. E. Anna Devi, Assistant Professor, Department of ECE, Sathyabama Institute of Science and Technology, deemed to be University, Chennai. Today's video lecture is on amplitude modulation. Amplitude modulation is the process in which amplitude of the carrier signal is varied with respect to the amplitude of the message signal, keeping the phase and frequency of the carrier signal constant. Amplitude modulation has wide applications. The important applications of amplitude modulation are: it is used for transmission of audio and video signal. Also, it is used in two-way mobile communications. Amplitude modulation is of four types: amplitude modulation with carrier, double sideband suppressed carrier amplitude modulation, single sideband suppressed carrier amplitude modulation, and vestigial sideband amplitude modulation. Today we are going to see amplitude modulation with carrier in detail along with this derivation. There are four types of amplitude modulation. They are amplitude modulation with carrier, double sideband suppressed carrier AM, DSB SC AM, single sideband suppressed carrier SSB SC AM, and vestigial sideband AM, VSB AM. Today we are going to see amplitude modulation with carrier in detail. So this is the graphical representation of amplitude modulation. This is the message signal which we are going to be modulated. The other name for message signal is baseband signal or modulating signal. This message signal is of low frequency, as well as the maximum amplitude of the message signal is Vm and the minimum amplitude is minus Vm. This is a sinusoidal waveform, so it is represented as Vm sin omega nt. And the carrier signal, we are going to modulate the message signal with the help of the carrier signal. Carrier signals are nothing but the generated waveform. So this signal will be having constant amplitude and high frequency. Since the frequency is of very high, the time period will be very small. So we are drawing with minimum time period. Now the amplitude modulation happens with the carrier signal and the message signal. The superimposition of message signal over the carrier signal is called as amplitude modulation, and the graphical representation of amplitude modulation will be like this. So the amplitude of the carrier signal rises when the message signal goes positive, and the amplitude amplitude of the carrier signal reduces when the message goes negative. Actually, this will be the envelope of the amplitude modulation represents the message signal. Now we are going to derive the amplitude modulated waveform. So first, let us start with the message signal. The message signal or the modulating signal is represented as Vm of t is equal to Vm sin omega mt. Here Vm represents the amplitude, maximum amplitude of the message signal, and omega m represents the angular frequency of the message signal. Now the carrier signal, this is also a sinusoidal waveform. The instantaneous sinusoidal waveform carrier signal is represented as Vc of t is equal to Vc sin omega ct. Here Vc represents the amplitude of the carrier signal, and omega c represents the angular frequency of the carrier signal. Now, as per the definition of amplitude modulation, the amplitude of the carrier signal is changed after the modulation. The change happens in this way: amplitude of the amplitude modulated waveform Vam is equal to Vc plus Vm of t. So this amplitude is the amplitude of the carrier signal, and this is the message signal as such. So Vc plus Vm of t is nothing but Vm sin omega mt. So we have represented Vc plus Vm sin omega mt. So taking the Vc constant as common, we can write 1 plus Vm by Vc sin omega mt. So now I have represented this Vm by Vc as Ma. So the equation gives Vam is equal to Vc into 1 plus Ma sin omega mt. So here Ma is nothing but the ratio of Vm by Vc, which is defined as modulation index or depth of modulation. So modulation index is nothing but the ratio of amplitude of the message signal to the amplitude of the carrier signal. Now let us see the derivation of amplitude modulation. To start with, modulating signal or the message signal, Vm of t is equal to Vm sin omega mt, where Vm represents the amplitude, maximum amplitude of the message signal, and omega m represents the angular frequency of the message signal. Next, the carrier signal. Carrier signal is represented as Vc of t is equal to Vc sin omega ct, where Vc represents the amplitude of the carrier signal and omega c represents the angular frequency of the carrier signal. As per the definition, the amplitude of the carrier signal is changed after the modulation. The change happens in this way: Vam is equal to Vc plus Vm of t. That is, Vc is nothing but the carrier amplitude alone is varied based on the message signal. So Vc plus Vm of t. So we substitute the Vm of t value from here. So Vc plus Vm sin omega mt. So when we take Vc as common, Vc into 1 plus Vm by Vc sin omega mt. So here we represent Vm by Vc by a new term, modulation index. This comes like Vc into 1 plus Ma sin omega mt, where Ma is nothing but the ratio of amplitude of the message signal by the ratio by the amplitude of the carrier signal. This ratio is called as modulation index or depth of modulation. So this is an important factor in amplitude modulation. The instantaneous amplitude of the amplitude modulated signal is given as Vam of t, which is equal to Vam into sin omega ct. This Vam is nothing but just now we have derived Vc into 1 plus Ma sin omega mt and sin omega ct. Just do the multiplication, we will be getting Vc sin omega ct plus Vc Ma sin omega mt sin omega ct. We know that sin A sin B is equal to cos A minus B minus cos A plus B divided by 2. Substitute this in the above equation. After substituting, we'll be getting Vc sin omega ct plus Vc Ma by 2 cos omega c minus omega m into t minus cos omega c plus omega m into t. So when we further multiply this interiorly, we'll be getting three terms. This is the amplitude modulated mathematical representation. So Vam of t is equal to Vc sin omega ct plus Vc Ma by 2 cos omega c minus omega m into t minus Vc Ma by 2 cos omega c plus omega m into t. So this will be getting three terms. The first term is nothing but the carrier signal Vc sin omega ct. The second term with lower frequency omega c minus omega m, we call this term as lower sideband. And the third term is higher frequency omega c plus omega m, we call this as upper sideband. So there are three sidebands in amplitude modulated with carrier. First one is the carrier signal, second one is the lower sideband, and the third one is upper sideband. So what we infer from this amplitude modulated waveform is, point number one, this representation is nothing but the time domain representation of amplitude modulated waveform. Second one is the carrier signal and the message signal are superimposed, and particularly in the carrier signal, the message signal is superimposed on the amplitude of the carrier signal. So we can see that the amplitude of the amplitude modulated waveform is identical to the amplitude of the message signal. Next point is, when a message signal is absent, that is if Ma is not present, Ma is nothing but Vm by Vc. If Vm is zero or the message signal is absent, then we will be getting only the carrier signal. So in the diagrammatic representation also, when we have no message, the amplitude of the carrier signal will be same as the amplitude of the modulated signal will be same as the amplitude of the carrier signal. And the next point which we can say here is, the frequency of the modulated signal is same as the frequency of the carrier signal. So now we will be seeing the frequency spectrum representation of AM waveform. When we try to plot the mathematical representation in the frequency domain, first at the carrier frequency omega c, the amplitude is Vc. Then at the lower frequency omega c minus omega m, that is the lower side band has an amplitude of Ma Vc by 2. Then the upper side band with a frequency of omega c plus omega m, the amplitude is Ma Vc by 2. Now let us find the bandwidth of this AM signal. We know that bandwidth is upper cutoff frequency minus lower cutoff frequency. So omega c plus omega m minus omega c minus omega m. So when we simplify this, we will be getting bandwidth is equal to 2 into omega m. That is, we come to know that the bandwidth is twice the time the frequency of the message signal. In today's video lecture, we have seen the definitions, derivations of amplitude modulation. I hope that all of you have understood amplitude modulation in detail. In the next video lecture, we will be seeing about frequency modulation in detail. Thank you.